After freeing a young girl from her unjust imprisonment in Jerusalem, Phryne Fisher begins to unravel a mystery concerning priceless emeralds, ancient curses, and the truth behind the suspicious disappearance of Shirin's forgotten tribe. This movie is the film version of the popular TV detective series Miss Fisher's Murder Mysteries. First of all, this movie looks cheap. It's not even shot in widescreen, which is a major letdown. Most of the film's visual effects are pretty bad. The bland production values might be less noticeable in the home market, where the film will ultimately end up and presumably make most of its money. But it sticks out like nobody's business on the big screen. Story-wise, it's a mess. There's not much wit in the dialogue, and Miss Fisher's proto-feminist age simply gets lost in all the blurry plotting. There's a distinct lack of energy here, and sadly, no amount of luxurious locations or lavish costuming can compensate for a film void of enthusiasm. The penny-pinching aesthetic is particularly noticeable in exterior city shots in which the background is blurred out, saving costs by reducing the need for period details. One of the film's biggest problems is the flavorless cinematography. While staging scenes, often simple dialogue exchanges, the cinematographer frequently moves the frame left to right, or right to left, or up to down, or in half-circle-like curving motions, attempting to jazz up a visual experience largely comprised of bland mid-shots. The film's big reveal is also very bad. Not only does it embrace one of the worst of all mystery movie clichés, it is heavily signaled throughout the film. Overall, this cult hit show's first big screen adaptation rarely gives the audience a cinematic feel, bogged down by a dialogue and flavorless scenes. Unless you have nothing else to watch, we recommend you to avoid this movie. This is a bad movie.